All new at noon, today is the day FGCU's baseball team gets back on the diamond to get their season started, and they are coming off the best season in program history, but did lose some key contributors. It's a time of the year when Dunk City, right, the basketball team gets a lot of attention, but let's bring in NBC2's Andrew McDevitt to explain how these baseball Eagles are filling the holes with players right here from our own backyard.
Well, Chad, when Coach Dave Tillett talks about recruiting, his number one priority is to fence in their backyard and keep these local players here at home. This year they did just that, and now if the Eagles hope to make it back to the NCAA tournament, these Southwest Florida kids will have to play a big role.
Anytime we can get an area kid that can stay home, it's just good. It's good for us. It's good for our community. And, boy, we've been pretty successful with the ones we do get.
You can say that again. The Eagles will have 7 players from Southwest Florida on their roster this season. 2 of them, Tyler Yeager from Riverdale and Mark Coffers from Barron Collier, scored the game-tying and go-ahead runs in the A-Sun Championship game last year.
It's nice seeing guys from our area coming to a school like this and helping out, try to make it a program and be known around here. And it just shows the talent level in Southwest Florida that it just keeps producing year in and year out.
This year, the Eagles needed a boost. They had 2 starting pitchers get drafted, along with their starting shortstop, and the program's all-time leading home run hitter graduated. But Southwest Florida produced in the form of Ida Baker shortstop Christian Prophet and Canterbury pitcher and third baseman Tyler Shuck.
Tyler Shuck, honestly, probably the hardest working kid I've ever met. He's out here every single day, 2 hours before practice. He's here on the weekends, taking extra cuts, taking ground balls, finding any way that he can to better himself.
Oh, Prophet, he's a great shortstop. I mean, we've had some great ones here, and I think as he develops, he will be one of those special players.
And let's not forget the 5th-year senior pitcher, Grandpa, as they call him, Gulf Coast alum Mario Leone.
Anything that I can do to help my team win, that's honestly the biggest goal that I have in mind is winning.
The Eagles open their season with a doubleheader today against Eastern Michigan. The first game's at 2, the second at 5:30. We'll bring you those results of the game tonight at 11. I'm live in the newsroom. Andrew McDevitt, NBC2.